girls have a bigger and more diverse society than ever before. The latest census data shows 2 million households have members from different ethnic backgrounds. Some 152,000 former customers of Bank Northern Rock are to receive an average of almost £2,000 in compensation following a paperwork error. £270 million will be paid out in refunded interest. Girl Power's back. A musical based on the Spice Girls songs is opening in London tonight. The girls are very excited to be on the red carpet.
Very excited.
What a privilege. The songs that we wrote, now West End cast are singing.
It's amazing.
Amazing. And to have Judy Kramer from Mamma Mia.
And Jennifer Saunders writing the book. Amazing.
Amazing. Really excited to be with the girls.
In sport, is a busy night of football action ahead, including a Premier League clash between strugglers Sunderland and Reading. Arsenal are at League Two side Bradford in the League Cup. That's the latest. I'm Danny Crawshaw.
Have you got friends or family throughout the world who would like to hear the news and events back home? Then why not tell them about EurFM? They can listen live on our website, EurFM.com, from across the world and send requests and stories from across the globe. EurFM, broadcasting locally on 101.4 FM and worldwide on www.EurFM.com. That's IURFM.com. Your community, your station, your world. This is your FM.
Stay tuned to 101.4 Uri's Your FM.
Gedi Satellite and Aerial are your local approved Sky agents. Sky TV, broadband and calls from just 69 pence per day. Gedi Satellite and Aerial will supply and install your free Sky Plus HD system with attention to detail and to your satisfaction. Call your local digital experts on 02837 538604 or check out our Facebook page. Sky's terms and conditions apply.
Bags of shopping Christmas style.
Bags of fashion to make you smile. Bags and bags of the latest names.
It's Christmas time at Buttercrane.
And now Buttercrane is open even longer with late nights till 10 p.m. to help make your Christmas shopping easier. Buttercrane now open Monday to Friday till 10.
Bags of value, bags of fun.
Christmas looks for everyone.
Bags of famous high street names, it's in the bag at Buttercrane. Happy Christmas.
Buttercrane Shopping, Newry City Centre.
Come to Spotless Car Wash, Railway Avenue, Monaghan Street, Newry, and get not just clean, but spotless clean with our new runoff technology for a shining spot-free finish. Take advantage of our new offer for a mini valet special, only £15. Beside Newry Fire Station at Railway Avenue, Monaghan Street, Newry, open 7 days a week from 9 a.m. Spotless Car Wash, when your car looks good, you look good.
McSwiggan Sports Bar, showing all live Premiership football, GEA and boxing events. Music every night till 1:30 a.m. and karaoke every Friday night. Visit our newly renovated bar with drinks promotions running daily. Pool, darts and function room available. McSwiggan Sports Bar. All pints Monday to Friday, only £2.50 till 7 p.m.
Sim!
Well, a very, very good evening to you. Fast approaching 7 minutes after the hour of 7 o'clock. You're very, very welcome along indeed to the GM selection right here on your FM with yours truly, Gerry Martin. Keeping you company right through until 9 o'clock tonight. And as per usual, we have a cracking show lined up for you folks. Live in studio with me this evening, it's Mama Kaz. I'm going to tell you a little bit about her in a little while, but I can tell you that you're in for a treat because she's going to do a live unplugged session here in studio with us. And this lady is a total blues powerhouse. I've been playing some of her tunes over the past few weeks here on your FM, so you may be familiar with her already. But if not, please stay tuned, as I say, you're in for a mighty treat. Okay, don't forget if you want to get in touch with the program, 077-66-40-41-42 is the text number. Text the word URFM, spelled I-U-R-F-M, followed by your message and name to 077-66-40-41-42. Or alternatively, you can indeed like our Facebook page and say hello to us there as well. Okay, music now from The Who. This is the classic Baba O'Reilly, 101.4 FM, URFM.
Here in the fields, I fight for my meals. I get my back into my living. I don't need to fight to prove I'm right. I don't need to be forgiven.
And the crew, of course, Teenage Wastelands, Baba O'Reilly, The Who. Okay, I did tell you we have another featured artist on the program this evening, another featured unsigned artist, and this evening I'm really looking forward to having live in studio with us Mama Kaz. As I said, this lady is just one powerhouse of a blues singer. I have compared her on the program before to the greats such like Janis Joplin, etc. And I tell you, I make absolutely no exaggeration. She's been recently described by a seasoned journalist as the voice that must be heard. Mama Kaz is the blues and soul sensation from East Belfast, who in her solo outings has raised the live performance musical bar in Northern Ireland. And what's surprising is the fact that we're only waking up to this unique talent on our very own doorstep. Anyway, as I say, Mama Kaz live with us here for an unplugged session, plus a wee informal chat, of course, too. We like to do that. And that'll be in or about 15 minutes' time, right here on your FM.
There's a red house
101.4, Newry's Your FM.
Hylogen, Armagh Road, Newry. We specialise in teeth whitening from just £99. Relaxing lines, dermal fillers, skin peels and much more. Call our professional team on 30 251 833 or see hylogen.ie. Hylogen loves your skin.
John Exhausts, 43 Forkhill Road, Clog. John Exhausts, providing a professional service for professional people. We supply and fit exhausts for all vehicles. Tire fitting, part worn tires, exhaust repairs and tow bar fitting. Guaranteeing the best value on exhaust rates. For a competitive quote, call John Exhausts on 302-666-22.
Finton Flood & Sons, independent funeral director. 6 and 8-seater stretch limousine hire starting from only £180. 16-seater party bus fully loaded. Check out our website, fintonfloodandsons.co.uk, or call us on 30838 082.
Barney's Pet Food Superstore, 36th Mile, Newry, for all your pets' needs and feeds. Now open our new self-service dog wash and grooming parlour. Come visit our store to view our large selection of food, bedding, grooming and training products. Call us on 3026 0099 or visit our website, barneyspetfoodstore.co.uk.
Newry City's Your FM.
Silver, closest gold to kiss.
There you go, folks. The cracking sound of the Horse Lips. The thing called Sword of Light. And just before the commercial break, we had Luke Kelly. R.I.P. Luke, indeed. And Hand Me Down My Bible. You're tuned to Your FM with the GM Selection, a.k.a. the Shoebox Show. And a very, very good evening to you. I want to say hello to a few people now who have said hello to us on the Facebook page. They are John Pepe. How you doing, John? Also, Christopher Oliver and the real Lorraine Boyle-Heaney. Thanks, indeed, for getting in touch via Facebook. Don't forget, if you'd like to get in touch with the studio here, there's two ways of doing it. You can get in touch via the Facebook page, or you can also text us here to 07766404142. Now, we will be giving that number out quite a few times over the course of the program, because live in studio with us this evening is Mama Kaz, our featured unsigned artist this evening. We're going to have a wee chat and a live unplugged acoustic session. Really looking forward to that indeed too. Anyway, more about that in a few minutes time. The reason I'm telling you to bear in mind the text number is because we have some prizes to give away. Yes indeed, first time ever on my program that I've had a competition. I'm all nervous now. I wasn't nervous about the interview, I wasn't even nervous about the unplugged session, but now Mama Kaz has come in and give me stuff to give away and now I'm nervous. Fair, not making me nervous. Okay, here's Bob Dylan, Maggie's Farm. After that, we're going to hear from Mama Kaz.
I don't want to work on Maggie's Farm no more. No, I ain't going to work on Maggie's Farm no more. I wake up in the morning, hold my hands and pray for rain. I got a head full of ideas that are driving me insane. It's a shame the way she makes me scrub the floor. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more. I ain't gonna work for Maggie's brother no more. He hands you a dime. He asks you with a grin if you're having a good time. And he finds you every time you slam the door. Kicks. His bedroom window is made out of bricks. The National Guard stands around his door. I ain't gonna work for Maggie's Farm no more. For Maggie's Ma no more. No, I ain't gonna work for Maggie's Ma no more. Well, she talks to all the servants about man and God and law. Everybody says she's the brains behind Pa. She's 68, but she says she's 54. Just get bored. I ain't gonna work on Maggie's farm no more.
Paul Dillon working on Maggie's farm. Okay, it's what time is it? See, I've lost the run of myself here completely, I can tell you. I mean, I completely have lost the run of myself here. It's 27 minutes away from the hour of 8 o'clock. Live in studio here with me is Mama Kaz, and we are we're going to have a good time. I can really see this. It's either going to descend into total chaos or it's going to be one of the best radio programs ever broadcast. You're tuned to Your FM. That's IURFM. Remember that if you're going to text into our competition a little later on, because we've loads and loads of prizes to give away. But right now, without further ado, I'm going to introduce you to the lady herself. Kaz, you're very welcome to Your FM.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Lovely to be here.
And even the journey here, I think, was a bit of a comedy show.
It was. It always is a comedy show when we go on the road. But on the way down, I have no water pump on the windscreen. Uh-huh. And so I had to buy a de-icer and stick my hand out the window. I hope there's no police listening. Stick my hand out the window and spray the de-icer on the window because the dirt kept freezing up the window.
What we're using for water.
Oh, stop. You're going to get me in trouble.
It's life on the road.
Absolutely. It does sound like a ball. It really does. Kaz, tell us a little bit about yourself first.
Right. Well, I'm songwriter first and foremost, and I'm a blues singer as well. And I've been on the scene. I've been singing all my life, but underground for more or less the last 15 years. And I've been working, gave up work to focus on my music and my songwriting. About 3-4 years ago, decided to move over to blues. But I have like two personas. Mm-hmm. I can write pretty, you know, sort of ballady stuff and belt out the growly blues stuff. So more or less just a bit late in the game for mainstream, as they would call it, but never too young to live your dreams.
Absolutely. Never too old to live your dreams. And have a bit of fun along the way too. So blues, is this something that you've always wanted to do from way back from you started playing music?
I don't think blues was necessarily my chosen, you know, growing up. When I was younger, I had auditioned for a show called Opportunity Knocks, and the pianist who was auditioning me asked me to investigate Etta James. So when I investigated, you know, I think I got a CD and left it, and then when I went back to investigate what kind of music I wanted, after years on the cover scene doing pop stuff and tried a bit of everything really, when I decided, when people kept saying to me, you've got to do blues, you've got the right voice, and I never really, I tried for 10 years to get onto the scene in Belfast, onto the blues scene, but it's a pretty small genre, and there's not really any gigs, and you know, you would go to see the likes of Rob McCulloch on a Thursday night at the Empire, and you know, some Lee Headley bands and stuff like that. So there wasn't really any for anybody for me to identify with or to look up to on the blues scene in Northern Ireland. So people said to me, right, Kaz, well, if there's nobody there, then you may as well get stuck in. But it was pretty hard because people didn't know what to do with me. Some thought I was screaming, some thought, you know, didn't class it as singing. So gave everything up and just went hammers and tongs, wrote enough songs to write about 20 albums, didn't like some, investigated my songwriting, and decided 100% I wanted to do blues, but yet keep my songwriting for the kind of message.
So whenever it was introduced to you that you had this unique sort of a bluesy soulful voice and you should investigate the likes of Etta James and that, where did you take it from there? Did you decide to look through right back through the blues from the 20s?
Oh my God, the earliest I had investigated back was Lucille Bogan.
Right.
From 1934, I think. If anyone was to Google a song called Shave Them Dry, it does exactly what it says on the tin.
Okay.
And I just was intrigued by these old blues female singers who, you know, like Bessie Smith and you know, these kind of powerful women. But it was the rawness of it that I loved. And it was that anything went. And that kind of song, as dirty as it may be, I just went, these are women in that time, in that era in America, you know, 1934, you know, these colored women were singing in the back bars of up and down the South. I just was intrigued by this, and I felt I connected with it. me being from Northern Ireland, wait, it's not expected to have that kind of voice. So I think my granny was an opera singer, so she taught me how to use my voice, use the power. She used to lay me down on the floor and stand on my diaphragm to give me that power. So when I, over the years, I wasn't a great fan of the standard blues tapes. I don't want to diss, you know, any kind of blues music. Blues music is at its core about your soul. But it was the great females. I mean, Etta James is my idol. And, you know, when she was doing St. Louis Blues was the first song that I came across of hers, and it broke my heart, this wailing cry. So for me, it's an opportunity to lose myself when I'm on stage and I'm singing the blues. I just disappear into a different world.
Okay, well, Cass, tell you what I want to do. Okay, I want to take you right back in a moment to where it all started. Okay, right back before the blues, right back to the very beginning of your story. But before we do that, is there any chance you'd play us one wee song? And introduce your compadre here as well.
My drummer, Johnny Skip Crawford. We have him sitting to my left on a little box called the Cajon. And he's 65 years of age. He's just recently turned 65. He is testament to never too old to enjoy
it. All I have to say is sometimes I wish this was television, because, folks, yeah, have to see this man. This guy is gas.
He's dapper, isn't he?
He is brilliant. He really is. This guy is gas. Absolutely. All fired up. And you're going to provide the percussion for us, Johnny, yeah?
Eh? Pre-mark.
Pre-mark. I thought he was pointing to a pacemaker.
So that. By your pacemakers in pre-mark.
He's plugged into me. I'm not going to last that one. Keep the show going before I die.
Okay, without further ado, Kaz, what are we gonna hear?
Well, I think I'll do something that you're not gonna play, or if you're gonna play, I'm not sure. It's a little song called "I Got the Blues."
You do.
And it's not 12-bar blues. I don't profess to be a great guitarist. My vocal is my first instrument, but I just really learned guitar to back my voice up. So it's a little "I Got the Blues."
Excellent. Take it away.
Stay tuned to 101.4 Yuri's Your FM.
Louis Boyd, Smith Street, Newry and Buttercrane Shopping Centre. Check out our amazing 123 offer in our suits department. Suit, shirt, tie and shoes for only £123. Back to school, we are now stocking a stylish selection of Roxy school bags and Kickers footwear. Louis Boyd's, Mill Street and Buttercrane Shopping Centre, Newry.
Yew Tree Dental Practice, Patrick Street, Newry, has just been awarded Northern Ireland Dental Team of the Year. Be part of the winning team. Register your details with Yew Tree and let Northern Ireland's Dental Team of the Year care for you. Yew Tree Dental Practice are now registering NHS patients. Call us on 302 57676.
Ward's Rockmount, Rathryland Road, Newry, serving hot food to go from 6am to 9pm. Ward's Rockmount, for everyday low prices and amazing weekly offers. Ward's Rockmount, for all your festive shopping. If you forgot it, we've got it. Ward's Rockmount would like to wish all their customers a peaceful Christmas and a prosperous new year.
Newry City's Your FM.
Well, you're very, very welcome back. And the time just gone 16 minutes away from the hour of 8 o'clock. Live in studio with me, it's Mama Kaz. And we're having some fun, I can tell you. Absolutely brilliant stuff indeed. Okay, you heard her play live along with Johnny on... What is that instrument that Johnny...
Cajon. It's a cajon.
A cajon.
He calls it a cajon, but it's a Mexican box. It's from Mexico, I think, and a little hole in the back, uh-huh. And it's just got a plate on the front, made in Taiwan, we think. And it has like a sort of a bass snare and hi-hat all mixed into one plate.
Absolutely, it's pretty brilliant. Genius. It's a fantastic sound, it's great, I have to say, anyway. Mm. Exactly, and no sticks.
No sticks, just his hands.
You mean you stretch with it? Okay, Kaz, where did this musical inspiration come from that you wanted to be involved in the music industry, and at what age did you start to realise that you wanted to be involved with it?
Well, I came out of the womb. I tell everybody I came out of the womb screaming in tune, as my mums used to say. But all my life I was quite... I'm in the beginnings of writing a book at the minute, and I'm on Mama Kaz book at Tumblr, and I just posted a part of it the other night about when I was young. It was all pretty much being told, threw up into the forefront, that mum and daddy had, you know, my mum didn't drink, but if dad had a party, Top of the Pops, every Thursday night, brought all his friends back or whatever, and local bands, my dad would have roadied, so he would have brought, you know, musicians back, and he would have jammed, but I would have been thrown up. I would have learnt how to harmonise by listening to the Eagles and all these men, you know, just pretty early, but I think my earliest recollection would be about 7-8 years of age, dancing around, being taken to pubs to perform for pound notes so my dad could drink.
And why not? And utilise every single opportunity, that's what I say. But anyway, okay, you mentioned that your grandmother was an opera singer.
Yes, she was a soprano.
Tell us about that and how that came about, that she got to train you and to...
Well, when I was growing up, I grew in my teenage years, my grandma was a Mormon.
Uh-huh.
And so I'd studied, you know, turned good living, and I don't know what happened to me after that, like I'm a pretty bad girl now. So you know, as I was growing up, I seen the choir, and I wanted to be in the choir because I'd been kicked out of the choir at school.
Now, when you mentioned the choir, is this a gospel choir type thing you're talking about?
Yeah, kind of hymn, you know, that not really... I always wanted to be in that kind of you know, mad gospel, screaming hallelujah stuff. But I couldn't conform to the soprano, alto, you know, all those different kinds of variations of singer. I was always a front singer and always being told no. So I was never chosen for the choirs in church or anything, but my granny had tried to control my voice.
Okay.
And so I was living with her, you know, about 6 months when I was 16, and she'd lie me down up against the wall, teach me how to breathe, use my diaphragm.
And what did you think of this at the time? Did you think this was great?
It was painful.
Right.
I thought I was being punished for something unbelievable, and she just kept saying to me, trust me, mm-hmm. trust me, this will stand you good stead. And
well,
I never ever imagined that, and it happens so naturally now, mm-hmm. you know, a lot of bad habits have happened over the years, but those bad habits actually add to a blues singer.
Mm-hmm.
Because you don't necessarily have to hold your breath and do those big par money notes.
Mm-hmm.
So you can get away with anything.
Mm-hmm. That's valid.
Within reason.
Absolutely. I don't think you're getting away with stuff here. I think you're actually creating a really unique voice. And I think it's wonderful. I mean, I have been playing some of your tunes over the past, well, a few weeks, suppose, over the past month.
Thank you.
And sort of the reaction I've been getting is sort of a comparison to Janis Joplin.
Wow.
And that's from listeners.
I know.
That have said that to me. And to me, that's
so
quite...
so massive.
That's quite an endorsement.
Do you better believe it? I mean, people, you know, PR people, you know, have you put on Belfast's and people, she's being compared to Etta James, Janis Joplin, Maggie Bell. I mean, they are such great honours. When you have journalists talking about you and, you know, to be able to support the likes of Van Morrison, you don't get those gigs for nothing. So it took me a while to understand that, yes, this is unique, that this is not that it wasn't a confidence issue, I think it was just because I didn't have anybody to identify with in Northern Ireland. I was always looking to America for inspiration, and when you didn't have money back then to spend on tapes, and when I was growing up, or so it was more or less Top of the Pops or Radio 1 on the Sunday afternoon.
Yeah, you had no instant access.
No,
anybody can click on a mouse now and get any tune they want.
Exactly.
And listen to it. I know exactly what you're saying. We didn't have that back then.
I felt restricted growing up.
Yeah.
When everybody was listening to Bross and Five Star, I was cracking up in my bedroom trying to understand why I didn't identify with the music. So when I discovered a few LPs, and my dad had pulled out an old record player that he had and threw it away when tapes first came in, and I remember listening to the St. Louis Blues by Etta James and Coco Taylor, Wang Dang Doodle. I remember, oh my god, this is me. What, this is me? What am I doing here? Why am I not in America?
Yeah, I can understand that completely. It's just a totally different vibe. You know, you weren't bombarded with a plastic pop in your head and thinking of something else. But in saying that, there was a sort of a period in your life where you wanted to get into music, obviously, and the only door open to you was to get into something that was like a covers type band. Tell us a little bit about that and how that came about.
For years, I realized that I could, you know, my blues voice hadn't developed then, but I did know that I was into different music. But I realized quickly that those big power ballady types, you know, the Dale and Leona Lewis and all back then, Whitney Houston. So I realized that I had a niche there and that I had one of the powerful voices on the scene. So I just monopolized on that. Done a few cover bands and then formed a girl band. And
funny, I was reading that in your bio about the girl band. But before we get there, okay, before we move into that vein, the Belfast answer to the Spice Girls, before we go there, tell me this and tell me nothing more. When you were out doing the covers, did you enjoy that or was it?
I did.
Right.
I did. No, I can't lie about it. You know, it was great money, and I mean, I would still do some now and again, you know, to bring in some money, but it sort of way sickened me in the end. Not, and it's not to take away from, you know, I've done it for so many
years. No, I can identify with that because an awful lot of artists, people
felt
that I've
like
talked
a musical
to,
prostitute.
Funny, that's a term that I've heard more than once from lots of different people. You do feel to a certain extent that you're going out and you're just doing the same thing.
And it's not even that, you know.
Nearly soul destroying.
The average punter or the average audience that you would be singing to in that scene, you're just another band.
Yeah.
They're not there to actually hear you, your songs, or connect with you. You're just another one on the conveyor belt of
And they'll come up at the end of the night absolutely rotten drunk and tell you, how good you are, I want to play, you should be playing Pop Pops.
You should be on the X Factor.
Yeah.
And I stand, and I still get it, and I go, no. Any self-respect is songwriter. I've tried all those competitions.
Right. Now, with that all in mind, tell us about the girl band.
The girl band was crazy.
Uh-huh.
at its height, it was like five girls. There was five of us, and it was just bonkers. And I was reliving my second child. I was having a second childhood, and my daughter Amy, who was in the band with me, and my son and his friend. He was a teenager, 16, 17 years of age. We toured up and down the country, over the border, and it was just lots of different, you know, crazy gigs.
What kind of material were you playing?
We were doing tributes more to all the greatest female artists that had, you know, that we could get our hands on. So it was pretty much from Bette Midler to Pussycat Dolls.
Right.
So it was just more or less a celebration of female empowerment, which is what I'm all about. Because
that sounds very like girl power.
Well, yeah. But Noel, I think when you say girl power, everybody thinks Spice Girls.
Yeah, yeah.
But let's come on, you know. I don't like taking away from people's talent, but that was a manufactured process.
But as is most of the music in the music industry today. Now, we could get into a whole conversation about that.
We could actually.
but we'll not. So, I mean, you're gigging all over the country, you're making a few quid, you've got your family around you as well.
Are we making a few quid? I wish you was.
In the girl band, no?
No.
All right.
Yes.
Stay with the program. Stay with us here. So basically, your turn, you've got your family with you to a certain extent, and there must have been some good times along the road as well.
Oh, there was amazing times. We had the best crack ever, but it burnt itself out really quickly. Mm-hmm. Because what happens when you're in demand and you're up and down the country, and you know everything from open air concerts to festivals, you know. Mm-hmm. You just at one point we were on the back of a lorry and there was thousands of people, and I just even there that's when I started to realise these people are crazy and they want all that dun 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 dun.
Absolutely,
dancing.
Yeah, absolutely.
And
yeah.
It wasn't me, you know. No. I'm nearly 40 in January. I had to stop at some time.
Well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to find out more about you after the news.
Okay.
So we are. I'm going to find out lots more about you, and we're going to hear lots more music from you. But to take us to the news, let's have a recorded track from you, and we'll talk about this one too, because this is all to do with our competition as well.
Make way for my noise. Make FM.com and live on FM 101.4 from Newry. This is Your FM News Update.
From the Sky News Centre at 8, it's now illegal for churches of England and Wales to marry same-sex couples. The Culture Secretary says gay couples can tie the knot in a civil ceremony or in a religious building, but institutions and individuals will not be forced to conduct such ceremonies if they don't wish to do so. Well, there are mixed views this evening to the announcement.
Until the Church of England accepts that it is a fundamental right and not just a wish, a grant, then we'll never be equal.
I'm super happy with the fact that any other religious establishment now can marry me.
The Northern Ireland Secretary has condemned the attempted murder of a female police officer by loyalists. Theresa Villiers says a total of 32 police officers have been hurt in the recent violence. Last night, a petrol bomb was thrown into a policewoman's car. Police have completed their initial investigation into the Jimmy Savile sex abuse allegations. 7 people have been questioned and 6 people arrested since Operation New Tree was set up in October. England and Wales have bigger and more diverse societies than ever before. 2 million households now contain members from different ethnic backgrounds. Sundar Kotwala, the director of think tank British Future, says it's inevitable.
People are going to meet, they're going to form families, and that everyday integration plays a very big role in taking something that was seen as a social problem. Will children be able to cope with different identities, to just being a fact that people grow up with?
In football and the Premier League, Sunderland lead Reading 1-0 in the clash of the strugglers. And while it's goalless between Norwich and Aston Villa in the standout game in the Scottish Cup, it's nil all as well between Motherwell and Aberdeen. The Spice Girls are reunited once again at the opening of the stage musical Viva Forever. Posh kept the audience waiting for curtain up after arriving late because she was reportedly stuck in traffic. It's written by Jennifer Saunders. That's the latest. I'm Danny Crawshaw.
The best in rock and metal music you're going to get anywhere in Newry, some Irish and a bit of crack. Rock and Mock is a show for you every Thursday from 7 to 9 on your FM 101.4 FM.
Stay tuned to 101.4 Newry's Your FM. Used Clothing Company, working with you today for a brighter tomorrow. We will buy your unwanted good quality clothing, shoes, belts, bed linen, curtains and handbags. For every 10 kilograms, we'll pay you £5. That's 50 pence for every kilo. Visit the Used Clothing Company at 1A Edward Street, Newry.
Something you wouldn't expect to hear.
Turn right at the next turning. Stop at the junction. Now, ask the nearest pedestrian where on earth you are.
And something else you wouldn't expect to hear.
A new Polo Madge from £11,440 with £1,500 towards your deposit when you buy on finance and 3 years servicing for £299. Now available at P&R Motors Volkswagen Merchants Key Newry. Conditions apply. 7.9% APR representative.
McKay Hairdressing, Mill Street, Newry. They're a well-appointed salon with over 30 years' experience and are specialists in bridal hairdressing. Fancy a new style? Speak to their professional stylists. Call McKay Hairdressing on 3083 5600.
Okay, very welcome back. We're into the second half of the GM selection. oh, dear. Oh. You're tuned to your FM 101.4 right across Newry and worldwide on the web. And live in studio, we've got Mama Kaz here. And she's just witnessed me pressing all the wrong buttons. So I wonder how this thing's still on the air, really, every Tuesday evening when I get in here. I just don't understand it.
It's my kind of room. I like rooms like this.
I think I'm just blessed by good fortune. I really am. You just see all the hands going like an octopus. Where's all the buttons? Right, we got the right one that time, anyway. Right, you're welcome back.
Thank you.
Okay, now we want to tell the people about this competition. You've got loads and loads and loads of goodies here to give away.
Yes,
what have we got?
We have, first off, the Mama's Express, which is the Mama Kaz Band single release.
Okay.
That's my blue side. And then Lipstick and Cocaine, my solo EP. And the music video two will be on, is on DVD as well with that. And my most recent project, my Naked Calendar. And what else have we got? We've got free entry into our big gig at the Erickle Inn in Belfast on Thursday night. So one person and a guest will get free access into the gig. We're going to have comedy, dance and band support acts and stuff like that. And then last in the pack is £100 worth of art vouchers from the Modern Art Gallery, who have sponsored me.
Tell us a little bit more about them.
Well, they, a friend of mine, well, both friends, Paul, who runs the Modern Art Gallery, has, he's very passionate about the arts and music, and I first came into contact with him when a local artist, Dee Craig, had contacted me about trying to help him raise money for his Just Given page for the Northern Ireland Children's Hospice. So he had, created this guitar. He took a Strat, and his pieces of his artworks is called Linenopolis, and it's about the dockers and the millies and the coffers, or I can't remember the word, in the mills. So it's trying to bring back, you know, keep the memory alive of the millies of it, and maybe an industry that's being forgotten about.
Millies. So, that's an interesting word. When I was younger, that meant
coffers.
But millies meant something totally different when I was younger.
No, I know. But that came from, you know, those ladies who worked in the mills.
Yeah.
You know, my God, 20 hours a day they used to work or something.
Yeah.
So he had created this piece on a guitar, on a Strat, of the Linenopolis ladies, and a bit about the White Star Line with the Titanic and stuff. So I created this tour, this guitar tour for him, and I called out to 12 bands across Northern Ireland, and they came on board. So we've created this 12-month tour. Each artist will take it for a month, then hand over to the next one. I mean, it's going across to the UK and going to be, you know, on stage with some amazing artists. And then
it's actually playable. It is.
Oh God, yeah.
Okay.
You know, it's a normal, it's a Strat-like guitar. It's not like a £3,000 guitar. The whole thing is about the art that's on it, and about celebrating that kind of Linenopolis project, the artwork that Dee has created.
Yeah.
I mean, he is such a stunning artist. He's so up and coming. I mean, one of his art pieces hangs in the City Hall in Belfast above the Mayor's Chambers. And so he's given away at the moment until January. This is part of the reason why. So if somebody walked up and, you know, his £3,000 for, say, for one of his pieces, stunning artwork, and he has an offer at the minute. I think it's, I can never pronounce it, he'll kill me, it's Escolia, I think it is, and it's a beautiful picture, painting of a lady with like a turban type thing on, and there's only so many of them left, and they're going for £50, you know, small kind of canvas. Because he's going to LA in January, so once they go, he'll be off to LA, and then I think it's New York he's going to. He'll be representing, you know, art here. And we all hooked up together, which led then the Modern Art Gallery. Paul, who got very frustrated, he says, like, I don't understand. You're amazing. What do we need to do to get you out there?
Right.
So I had said to him, look, well, I'm doing a Naked Calendar. And he says, well, that's photo art. Let's promote it.
Mm-hmm.
And he has sponsored me. He's designed him and Adam from, I can't remember, the design company. It's really silly of me. Who have helped design. Now, this calendar that you have was a trial run that I refused. I didn't like it. So when Paul offered to help me with he's made an absolute amazing calendar. It's a stunning piece of work. So it in itself is a piece of art.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll be launched on Thursday night.
Excellent. So basically that covers all these fantastic prizes that you're giving away here. So we have the calendar, and we have the £100 voucher.
Yeah.
For the
Art Gallery.
Plus we have the new single.
The DVD.
DVD. That's a DVD.
That's the music DVD. Which my daughter stars in the music video.
Excellent. And that is Lipstick
and cocaine.
Plus we have
the EP of Lipstick and Cocaine,
which I hid over here.
It's in front of me.
I got it. So that's that one. And we also have
Mama's Express by the Mama Casbah.
And we have some tickets as well.
We have free entry on the guest list. So whoever wins will be entitled free to our gig. It's our Mama Kaz Band album fundraiser Christmas extravaganza.
Okay. Well, you've heard all that, people. If you want to enter our competition, well, we're really not going to have a competition. Just
I think we'll pick a number out of the hat.
Okay.
Whoever comes in.
Okay, so basically, just text in with your name. Okay, just text in to the studio here, and the way you do that, I think, is 07766404142. That's 07766404142. Now you have to text the word URFM, which is spelled IURFM, followed by your message and your name. Okay, so basically you don't need a message, just text IURFM plus your name to 07766404142, or if you prefer 07766404142. Alternatively, get in touch via the Facebook page. Okay, that's Facebook.com/IURFM.
And we'll post it worldwide.
Absolutely.
I'll throw that in with the postage stamp.
There you go. You've heard straight from the lady herself. So what more can we tell you about that? So please do get involved. Lots and lots of great goodies there. As I say, it's the first competition I've ever had on the programme. So if you do want to get those goodies, if you want to win those, 07766404142, text the word IURFM, that's your FM, followed by your name. Simple as, or indeed get in touch via the Your FM Newry Facebook page. Okay, just to give you a wee taste or two of the DVD and the EP that's up for grabs, we're going to take the recorded version, the studio recorded version of Mommy Kaz's Lipstick and Cocaine right here on your FM. Get in touch, win the prizes, they're class. Okay, Right, this could only ever happen to me. Okay, I tell you what we'll do. We'll change the plan slightly. Would you guys like to sing for us instead? Oh, dear God.
Oh, I love it. Famous. I love it.
Absolutely.
Madness and Mayhem are my middle name.
Okay, listen, guys, I'd rather have you play live in studio anyway. So what are we going to do this time?
I think what we'll do is Can't Afford Me, which is the bonus track off the Mama Kaz CD, or the Mama Kaz Band CD.
Okay.
Which I'm also giving away. This can go out to everybody. 100 free downloads. So if you go to my Mama Kaz page and private message on there, and it's MAMA space KAZ, if you private message me, I will send you the link and a code to download Can't Afford Me.
Okay, and this is on Facebook?
This on Facebook.
Okay, absolutely.
All right.
Way down the road with my soul's in tow, when the river courses by the daily chore, well, I can't see. Lord, I can see so clear. So don't you stop me moving just 'cause you can't afford me. Say you love me well, you're a waste of space. Looks like you want me in my lonely place. Well, I can't see. Lord, I can see so clear. So don't you stop me moving just 'cause you can't afford me. And your dues, I've walked a lifetime, so come home, show me your moves, 'cause I can't see. Lord, I can see so clear. So don't you stop me moving just 'cause you can't afford me. So don't you stop me moving just 'cause you can't afford me. So don't you
Excellent, 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 excellent. I really enjoyed that. That worked so much better than the CD player, so it did. Okay, first class stuff. Okay, let's get back to your story.
Okay.
Now, we have had, over the course of the program, chatted about various people that you've met along the way. Mm. First of all, Opportunity Knocks. Yes. That was a tremendously enormous program. It was the X Factor of its time.
It was.
And indeed more, because it was more variety, really.
About talent. Uh-huh. It still was pretty manufactured. Well, it all is manufactured, but I was 12 years of age, and I can remember... I can remember the goings on. I was still ways. I was pretty streetwise from an early age. So it was London Weekend Television then. Mm-hmm. And I can remember watching the older people, you know, and I was running about in this ball gown. And
How did you get there? Well, how did that come about?
My granny kidnapped me out of school. She did. My dad wouldn't let me.
So was your granny sort of the driving force behind you to get you out there and get you...
Yeah, she tried so hard, bless her. Uh-huh. And so she kidnapped me, and my mum actually just kidnapped her and all.
Right.
And took me to the King's Hall, mm-hmm. it was then. And when you went into King's Hall, when it's not a concert, there's like different rooms or whatever, or they separate the stage type. So they had the chairs... It was like theatre seating, you know, like stalls. And you had to walk down, and there was just this grand piano, sparkling, just black, shiny. It was absolutely stunning. And nothing else, just a microphone stand. Mm-hmm. And so I went up, and the pianist said to me, "Yes, young girl, what are you singing?" And I was petrified, still bossy, as I tell everybody, still bossy. I said, "Well, I'm singing Once I Had a Secret Love." I can remember, you know. And stage over the years has taught me to talk a little better.
And avoid Calamity Jane.
No, but then it was like, "Only get your gun, never mind, Calamity Jane's coming through." And so I sang Once I Had a Secret Love. Mm. And it was beautiful. And it was the first time I'd ever played with a live instrument. But I walked off afterwards, and he tapped me. And I was actually telling this story to a few interviewers who were interviewing me in Washington. And he just gently grabbed me on the shoulders, and he said, "Have you ever heard of Etta James?" And I went, no, where is she?
Anyway. She lived on our street, didn't she?
So, and he says, "Well, get your grandmother to let you listen to it."
Uh-huh.
And my grand did. She did find me a tape of Etta James, which I then rediscovered later on when I went back to blues.
Brilliant. I'm sure that was a class find.
Unbelievable. Uh-huh. And I can't even find it. Over the years, probably just got lost.
That's these things do, yeah.
And actually, we were in another radio station last night, and they have this massive vinyl connection. Oh, and the guy just happened to say to me, "No, that's all getting dumped." And I went, I nearly choked, because I had found a 1969 Nina Simone, which is another great idol of mine, and this LP cover. I was like... I had shivers up my, you know, goose pimples on my arm. This was actually in, and nobody cared. Huh. I was like, "Oh my God, don't be throwing this out. Give it to me, give it to me."
And did they give it to
you? No, they didn't. I didn't want to torture them, though, because there's hundreds.
You just say, "I'll a recycling centre next door to me, I'll take that."
But that kind of, those kind of things people don't appreciate.
Yeah, yeah.
The younger audience of today wouldn't, you know, most of them don't comprehend the work and the effort that it would have went into that vinyl process, and that's why it's so special. And to have like a 1969, probably not worth a great amount of money, but the sentimental value for me
absolutely
would be enormous.
Okay, well, so that was the early sort of stage of trying to break into the music business. Yeah. And where it went from there, your sort of introduction to Etta James and that kind of thing, which you touched on briefly before. And then we obviously talked about you doing the cover bands and all the rest of that kind of thing. So you've rediscovered blues.
Yeah.
We're at that stage now where you're sort of split personality, dare I say. Two personas here.
100%.
We've got the blues persona, which is more affiliated with the band.
Yeah.
Tell us a bit about the band. Who's in the band and what's the pedigree there?
Well, very high pedigree, considering we have our Johnny here, who's played on stage with Gary Moore, mm-hmm. Eric Bell, you know, some of the most amazing artists to come out of here. So, and he's stuck here with me.
Well, he's enjoying himself.
Yeah, he loves it.
Yeah,
it's so much fun, Gerry.
Yeah,
so much fun.
Yeah, I can tell. I absolutely can tell this man's really thoroughly enjoying himself. Yeah. Really, really keen.
I say this is my first chance, and this is his last.
Yeah, all
absolutely.
And then we have on bass, which is Mr. McKenzie. Ali, uh-huh. Two gigs, we call him, bless him.
Right. What's the story behind that?
Ali is one of the finest, in my opinion, he's probably the finest bass player for the stuff that I like. Uh-huh. He's very melodic and he's kind of jazzy, blues, all the stuff he does. And I always joke with him, you know, I go by the bass. You know, I love Johnny to death, but I always seem to go by the bass line. Mm-hmm. I think that's back to listening to blues in the early. And he actually joked with me one day, and we were talking about like Susan Tedeschi, and he went, "Oh my God, because I didn't think you actually liked anything pre 1930. I went, "Yeah, uh-huh. I do. 1950s too." And then we have Peter Spratt, mm-hmm. who is outstanding. He thinks he's the musical director. We let him think he's the musical director. Talks awfully polite and all that.
Okay, yes.
But yes, so he organises us. Well, he thinks he does.
Every band has to have at least one guy like
yes,
that.
Yes, we do.
Have to.
And I mean, they are established. They are renowned on the local scene in Belfast, up and down the country. They play with, you know, so many have played with so many different. I mean, Johnny, you and Peter were actually in the Martown reunion plant. Well, he performed with you.
Forgot his name already.
So yes, I mean, I had other bands. You know, I had another, which was the Mama Cuz Blues Band before, but it just wasn't going the way that I wanted it to. So I gave it up and went acoustic. And this just happened by total accident when we were performing in Enler Delta Blues Club in Cumber, which all the blues musicians and fans of the music, we go down there on a third Sunday of every month and meet up. And I was focusing on the acoustic stuff away, you know, kicking up and down the country doing that, when Johnny met Peter and he jammed and he says, let's do something. And it just, I never expected this to happen.
So a band was born, basically?
A band was born. Mm-hmm. And it was our anniversary, actually, for 1 year there on the 22nd of November.
Belated happy birthday to the Mama Jazz Band.
It was crazy.
Okay.
We're pepper sober.
No, that is true.
Okay. You want to give us another tune?
No problem.
Okay, well, what are we going to have?
I think, yes, Johnny is shouting at me. This is his favourite song. I don't know, it's one that I don't like playing it out. I love the song, I wrote it, of course, but I prefer the way the band does it. It's a lot more softer, and it's stunning when the band do it, and it's going on the album when we raise the money, because everybody's so skint at the minute, so the fans, it's going to be an album funded by the fans.
Uh-huh.
So that'll be pretty cool. But it's called Don't Make Mama Cry. And I always say to everybody, I was always writing stuff about being dumped all the time. Because I choose now to stay single.
People listen to this will think I'm fierce cruel. You're talking about getting dumped and he's making me laugh. Nobody can see him making me laugh.
I know.
The problem is, Gerry, I can't find anybody to dump me. I think we're at 104.
Yes, this is an official call out to any ladies in Newry.
Right.
And my drummer is in need of female companionship. You must drive though, because he can't see.
He's too busy hanging out the window spraying out the de-icer.
We've got him off now.
Okay. We're fast approaching meltdown here.
Yes,
okay,
exactly.
take it away, folks.
I think I've had about 3 hours sleep in the last 3 days, so I will melt.
I stopped snoring at night. I'm in my headboard. Did you see Nick Rivers last night? We've had a headboard. She's only one of them.
Oh, God, please play some music.
This is a little Don't Make Mama Cry. I'm on Johnny now. Composer. I can see you over. solo. Shows how far you really go. Said ooh, ooh, ooh. Don't make mama cry. You're always for yourself. I said, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Ba 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 ba. No, 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 no. Ooh, don't make mama cry. So go be who you are. Oh, you won't get very far. You'll end up all alone. And now I said, ooh, yeah, ooh, ooh. Ba 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 ba. Don't make me cry. Don't make me cry. Don't make me cry.
World Travel, Northern Ireland's premier independent travel agency, is now open at Drumlane Mill, the Keys Shopping Centre, Newry. For all the best deals on family holidays, cruises, long-haul luxury and exotic weddings and honeymoons abroad, contact the experts, Club World Travel, on 3025 7555. That's 3025 7555.
Cotton Prints Direct, Camlock Road, Newry. Sale now on at their curtain fabric outlet with discounts of up to 50%. Thousands of metres of quality curtain fabric, lining, accessories and more. Ready-made curtains from just £8.99 a pair. Call Cotton Prints Direct, Lockbrook Industrial Estate, Camlock Road, Newry on 30 839 875.
Everyone's looking for the best deals around when it comes to fuel prices. Well, look no further than Conlon Service Station Omeath. Travel that bit further into Omeath and save on your sterling, filling your car up for less, only at Conlon Service Station Omeath. Conlon's Omeath, stretching your sterling.
Newry City's Your FM.
Strong me.
to be, searching for the end to find the real me. Well, I listen to my music, not really being free. Too many broken bridges stop me being me. You said, don't you know, don't you know, don't have the time for me. You said your mind's in a bad place, so you had to go. You said, don't you know, don't you know, don't have the time to love me. You said your mind's in a bad place, so you had to go.
Solo side of Mama Kaz, our featured guest artist on the program here this evening on your FM 101.4 across the Newry area and live right around the world on the World Wide Web. If you've just joined us, you've missed some absolutely cracking fun here in studio, I can tell you. It's been a lively evening. And of course, some great performances from Mama Kaz live unplugged here at your FM.
You see your mind's in a bad place.
Okay, competition, just to remind you, we have a load of Mama Kaz goodies to give away. And I mean a load of them. If you'd just like to remind the people out there, Kaz, again, all the goodies that we have to give away.
Alright, Mama Kaz Naked Calendar, Mama Kaz Band Single Release, Mama Kaz Solo Project Lipstick Cocaine CD and the Music Video DVD, and £100 worth of vouchers from the Modern Art Gallery in Belfast, and two free on the guest list. So you can bring, you bring yourself and some and a friend. You can maybe bring Johnny and you'll get him free on Thursday night at our Christmas extravaganza at the Eric Glen.
You get a net out with me, providing to bring a purse.
Good man, Johnny, good man. Okay, so that's absolutely some brilliant prizes there, bar the last one. So, if you'd like to win all those goodies, one person is going to scoop all those goodies. Text the word IURFM, that's your FM, to 07766 40 4142. That's 07766 404142. Just text the word IURFM, all one word, your FM, plus your name, of course. Don't forget to give us your name so we know who you are. And as I say, one lucky listener will get all those absolutely fantastic prizes, so don't miss out. Alternatively, if you don't want to text us, you can get in touch via the Facebook page. Let's just go on to our Facebook page, IURFM Newry. That's your FM Newry. Get in touch there. Just drop your name for the competition. Just write the word competition, or just write your name, just anything at all.
Johnny's name.
So that's all you got to do. And as I say, we will pick a winner before the end of the programme, and one lucky winner will win all those cracking prizes. Okay, Kaz, East Belfast Arts Festival, Vaughan Morrison, yes. Sharing a stage. What was that like?
Crazy. Brilliant. And a great moment and a great memory to be chosen to support. I mean, there was 9 acts. So to be chosen, I mean, they windled it down. I think they had like 30 acts in line for it. So I was just proud to stand there and represent East Belfast.
Mm-hmm.
You know, brilliant opportunity, but the sound, to be on that kind of stage. Technically, we weren't actually on the same stage because he had his own rolling stage that came from behind us.
Aye.
But same gig, same whatever.
On the bill.
On the bill.
That's,
yes.
that's all it takes to get noticed and get out there and do your thing. Yeah. Speaking of opportunities, tell us a little bit about the opportunity that's winging your way this Sunday in Dublin.
The Music Review on Sound Awards.
Who are they and what are they?
Music Review magazine from Dublin, and they do so much work for unsigned artists up and down, you know, north and south of the border. They have an online. You can subscribe to the magazine online. You know, they have MRU TV, and you can hook up with other unsigned artists across Ireland. So this is the first ever Irish Unsigned Music Awards, and it's going to be in the Mercantile Hotel in Dublin, Dame Street in Dublin, this Sunday. And Mama Kaz Band are nominated. Well, we were nominated and made it through to the final five as Best Blues Act.
That's quite an achievement.
Yes.
I mean, we're talking about the whole country here, basically, and you guys have been nominated through that and down to the final five.
It's amazing because, for me, you know, I've been working so hard to try and get the Mama Kaz brand out there, whether no matter what it is, it all leads back to me. And that sounds a bit pretentious, doesn't it?
No, absolutely not.
But you know, but I'm on the road, and
you're the one selling this thing.
Yeah, so it's great. That's why it means so much when somebody, you know, and this came out of nowhere.
Mm-hmm.
Pauline McDermott Smith from Impact Promotions in County Cavan, she nominated us and put me up for it, and she has been a great support to me and an absolute Entertainment Ireland, who are covering the event.
Mm-hmm.
And they're from, you know, Dale works here out of the bathhouse in Newry, and alongside that, for Newry itself, Alison McGrath has been nominated. She's made it through to the final in the soul jazz category. So we've both hired a coach, and we're bringing 16 friends with us to Dublin on Sunday, and fingers crossed for us, we may come home with some gongs.
Well, hopefully so, because next Tuesday evening I will be my last programme this side of Christmas, obviously, so I'm hoping for good news to tell the listeners out there, so I am.
We hope so, fingers crossed.
So, give us another tune.
Oh, right, I put the guitar and all down there. Because Johnny was falling asleep.
Yeah, I've heard you speaking before.
Okay, what are you going to give us this time?
I think, I've lost track of what we've been doing.
I'll keep you right, love.
I think we should do Love Highway.
Lovely stuff.
This is one of the first songs I ever wrote.
Is that nice song,
No.
Oh,
he panics because his timing as he gets older is a bit off.
That's my Scotch, not my timing.
This is about you know, finding that true love, and you know, you know where it is, you know who it is, but you can't get to it somehow. May it be long, you know, a long distance relationship, somebody's away, you know, working overseas or whatever. So this is just within my sweet days, as I like to call it, when I first started songwriting. So
And a friendly service, it has to be the Bureau de Change in Buttercrane Shopping Centre. Take advantage of our convenient opening hours, keen rates and many years of experience. And we're even an outlet for the National Lottery. Telephone 302 63207 and enjoy commission-free currency exchange at the Bureau de Change Buttercrane Shopping Centre.
Auto Service Centre, 8 Armagh Road, Newry. For all your vehicle servicing, repairs and MOT checks. Diagnostic specialists on all vehicles. Motor Industry Code of Practice and Good Garage Scheme approved. Auto Service Centre Newry, offering a dealership level service at a fraction of the price. Call us on 302 60538. That's 302 60538.
JT Carpets, for quality carpets, wooden floors and vinyls. JT Carpets, for household furniture and a huge selection of rugs. JT Carpets, for friendly, experienced staff, free estimates and delivery. Call us on 302 66464. Visit our website, jtcarpets.com, or call into our showroom at 1A Edward Street, Newry. JT Carpets, we buy by the mile, so you save by the yard.
Newry City's your FM.
Well, you're very, very welcome back to the programme. You're tuned to your FM 101.4 right across Newry and worldwide on the web. Live in studio with me, Mama Kaz. And Johnny, I have to say as well, too. He's some crack, absolutely. Okay, you heard Mama play live just before the commercial break, and we're going to have hopefully at least one more between now and 8 o'clock. We're going to try and see maybe if we could squeeze into it. I've a little funny thing, we might just get away with that, you know. Okay, right, we were talking about the competition in Dublin on Sunday, the MRU, and something like that, okay, do you think it's possible that that could maybe lead to something bigger further down the line? Is there any hope at all that maybe
You always have to believe stuff like that will give you, that will, you know, launch onto a new platform, and that's what MRU is about.
Will there be record executives there, that kind of thing that you can...
I'm not sure. I know that there's... each award is sponsored by different businesses and stuff. I think... our category is like Live Loud First, who is sponsoring that, Absolute Entertainment, who are from Newry, and they will be sponsoring one of the awards as well that they'll be handing out. So I think it's kind of, it's another gateway, it's another opening, you know, and there'll be bands, you know, there'll be acts performing on the night, press will be there.
See, that's very important, the media being there.
Definitely.
Absolutely, because if they pick up somebody who's not signed, and if they run with it, obviously at the end of the day that can create big waves and make the A&R executives or whatever take notice.
Well, if you really see if anybody goes to research A&R online, I mean, any songwriter or unsigned musician is always pretty much aware of what is going on in the industry. And our email boxes would fill up with these offers from A&R companies, but the thing is, there's very, very few record deals out there now.
Yeah.
You have to be pretty spectacular to secure one of those so-called big deals, but which aren't even big deals anymore.
No.
So what a lot of, I mean, my aim eventually would be to create a Mama Cass label. And that I could represent myself.
Well, at the end of the day, I mean, let's face it, and I absolutely mean no disrespect here, it's not the singles market that you're after.
No.
No, I mean, we're talking albums here.
Yeah.
This is what we want to create. That,
yeah,
that brand, that sound, exactly. Get out there, get away from the, what is it, the repetitive loop radio,
yeah,
play.
Exactly.
End of the, I know some of it's a niche market, and some of it might not be. You could be talking late night radio and stuff like that, yeah, along those lines too, but there is a market for that.
There definitely is, and for blues, you know, I mean, I say the guys all the time, you know, like, okay, what happens if we get this, and what happens if we get this? And Ali, God bless him, he would always go, you know, don't be too presumptuous, don't see too much into the future. But I have to be like that, because when I spend 3 days at a time, you know, not eating, not sleeping, to try and create a new song or something, or write a piece or do whatever I'm doing, I'm seeing the end game. I'm seeing what I want, and what I want is maybe a tour with my band around Europe, maybe get to America. There's starting a build up of American interest on me, and a lot of online radio stations out there are already playing stuff. I mean, I'm getting tweeted by a lot of Washington radio, you know, supporters. So the fan base is out there.
It's starting to grow.
It's the money. You know, I don't have the money to go out around the world and represent my country, that this is what Northern Ireland or Ireland has produced. I don't have that money, and it's a shame that nowadays so many artists like me have to resort to literally nearly begging to get our music out there.
Just to get marketed?
Just to get marketed. And I'm pretty good at marketing myself, so it's, you know, it's all about the brand. It's all about as much, I have many different hats that I try to put on, so it's all about getting my name out there.
Okay, well, we've had, speaking of hats and putting on hats, I'm not even going to look at his hat. Speaking of hats, I mean, we've had the solo, the ballad type, the singer, that is Mama Cass. We've had the blues powerhouse with the band, that is Mama Cass. And then we've got the author, that is Cass.
I wouldn't say author.
No, we're getting there from what I can see. Tell us about that.
Well, it's a work in progress. And there was a friend of mine, Allison, in Seattle, on Twitter, who I've been reading her stuff, and she was just we were talking, and I said, you know, I've loads of stuff in my head, everybody keeps telling me I should write it down, and I can be quite the comedian sometimes. Me and Johnny, when we're out, you know, we're like a little, they call us Kaz and the Coffin Dodger with a K. So and I think one, it was her that said to me, you know, just do it, just test it out. So I took it upon myself and started up the Tumblr, and it's really only been, you know, I'd been writing, again, secret. I do things in secret for a while, and then I unleash them to the public. but it seems to be getting good response, and, you know, my peers and a lot of musicians that I look up to, I mean, Jed McConkey, who produced Lipstick and Cocaine, I was laughing the other night. He says, no, guys, actually, it's quite good. It's quite good. Keep at it.
Exactly.
And that meant the world to me, because, you know, I respect him as a producer and a musician.
Well, what's the inspiration behind it? You've got so much else going on. Where are you finding the time, for one thing?
And I don't know.
You know, you're just living on caffeine, are you?
And do you know what? It's sleep and music. That's all. I consciously gave up work to do this, because this is my passion, and the reason being was because music saved my life, so I want to give something back.
Okay.
It soothes my soul. You know, this is what I'm born to do. This is the reason I'm still alive. I should be dead by now, but I'm here. I'm ready to tell the story, in the hope that, one, it will help other people out there. Two, of course, I want to sell some records. Three, that I can share it around the world and experience. You know, I work hard. I really do work hard, 24/7, 365 days a year. So I think, you know, I've earned it, and I want to enjoy it. I don't want, you know, of course you got to work hard, but I want to sit back and ride the wave. And
I understand that completely. And is this kind of like a documentation along the way?
Yeah.
Then?
it's a sort of journal biog. I'm pretty open with the public about my life, and so there's no real surprises. If you even go onto my Facebook, there's notes there, or, you know, about my history. Someone had tried to sell my story to the Sunday World and stuff like this, so I just got it all out there. You know, different magazines and stuff have done pieces on me, and it's just about honesty. That you people can come through hard times, but the book is about. I will probably eventually go through, you know, my past and what makes me, why Mama Kaz is here. And Mama Kaz is my alter ego, of course, and but she is the strength to me of all the women that I've ever came across in life, all the strong women who I looked up to, and all the women that I would like to help, all the women who are sitting there who maybe don't think that they're worth anything. When I used to feel like that, and I know what that felt when I was a single mother and going through depression. So for me, as Mama Kaz, I'm standing up for those women, but also for the strong women who have a right to be there.
Well, do you know what? I think that just about sums it up, and I think that says it all. No, absolutely I do. I think that's fine sentiments, and I think what's more over the just fine sentiments, I'm in the room with you, and I actually see that you're, you know, that's coming from the heart.
Oh, thank
you. Every word you're saying, you know what I mean? It's a life lived.
It is.
And
they always say you can't sing the blues unless you've been through them.
Absolutely. Speaking of singing the blues, I think we're going to have to wrap it up at that. And maybe you could squeeze one more wee tune in for us.
Well, I tell you what, we'll not do blues. We will do Lipstick and Cocaine. We haven't played it. It jumped earlier on, didn't it?
That's correct, yeah. I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll reveal the competition winner directly after this,
okay.
Too.
No problem.
Okay, take it away.
I'm going to dedicate this to Julie and Adele from Absolute Entertainment Ireland, and also Pauline McDermott-Smith from Impact Promotions. Lipstick and cocaine, hurting my brain, laying in my bed on my head, feel the pain. The uniformed man at the door says, come with me, darling, it'll be okay. He says,
come with me, darling, it's time. can see. Lipstick and cocaine, I'm all clean for me.
There we have it. Mama Cass. Cass, many thanks indeed for coming
Thank
in the studio.
Thank you, Gerry.
Thoroughly enjoyed having you here.
We've
with
had a ball.
The live session. Yeah, it's been good fun. Thanks again. I'm really, really, really wishing you all the best for Sunday night.
Thank you.
And looking forward to you. Let us know what happens, and hopefully we'll have good news to tell the listeners here.
We'll be tweeting and Facebooking on Sunday night on the way home. I haven't had a drink in 3 months, and that's my time.
And you're just well overdue then. Okay. Well, good stuff. That just about wraps up the GM selection for another week. I'll be back next Tuesday to do it all over again. But before we go, our competition winner, collecting all of the Mama Kaz goodies, is, let's pick one here from the text. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 at random. Okay, let's go for lucky 7. And number 7 is Shawnee McKee. Shawnee, well done to you. We'll be giving you a wee ring after the show. You'll be getting all those great Mama Kaz goodies indeed. Okay, as I say, I'll be back with you next Tuesday to do it all over again. And indeed, next Tuesday will be my last program this side of Christmas, and indeed this side of the new year. So I'll take the opportunity to wish you all a very happy Christmas, and indeed a peaceful and prosperous new year as well. So, seeing as next week's program will be my last one before the new year and before Christmas, I'm going to feature all the unsigned featured artists that we have featured over the course of the past few months. So you'll be hearing more Mama Kaz next week, more Ian Roberts, and more Jegises, and quite a few others. Matty James coming your way after the news. Until next week, from me, take care, bye-bye, see you soon.
On digital at yourfm.com and live on FM 101.4 from Newry. This is Your FM News Update.
From the Sky News Centre at 9. The Church of England will be banned by law from offering its same-sex marriages under new legislation. Other religious organisations will be able to opt in to providing ceremonies under this scheme, which is due to be introduced before the next election. The Culture Secretary and Equalities Minister Maria Miller announced the proposals in the Commons earlier.
The Church of England and Wales have explicitly stated that they do not wish to conduct same-sex marriage. The legislation will explicitly state that it would be illegal for the churches of England and Wales to marry same-sex couples.
A petrol bomb attack on a female police officer in Belfast has been condemned by the Northern Ireland Secretary. Theresa Villiers says the attack was totally unacceptable.
There is nothing remotely British about what they're doing. They are dishonouring and shaming the flag of our country with their lawless and violent activities. They discredit the cause that they claim to support.
A British student left critically ill after a snowboarding accident in the French Alps is unlikely to